Hey, SEC family. Thank you for joining me today for another devotion. Today, I want to talk about how to be angry without sinning. We all have hard to love or hard to deal with types in our life, people who drive us crazy. One of the amazing things about these crazy makers in your life is how quickly they can flip you from being happy to angry in a split second. They know how to push your buttons. Let me just give you some facts about anger that I found out. The average woman loses her temper 3 times a week. The average man loses his temper 6 times a week. Are we surprised? Some of us are even above average. Women get angry more often at people. Men get angry more often at things. Computers, mechanical problems, things like that. And the place you're most likely to express anger is at home, because we get angry more often and more intensely at those we love than we do strangers. That's obvious. Often, people who make you the most angry are those you love the most, because they have the greatest potential to hurt you, or to offend you, or to irritate you, or to just frustrate you. I want you to know that anger is not always an inappropriate response. It's not always wrong. Anger is not always wrong, but uncontrolled anger is always wrong. In fact, there are many situations where anger is the only appropriate response. Actually, anger could be evidence of love. Somebody tries to hurt my kids or my wife or my grandkids, I'm going to get angry. That's an appropriate response. There are some things that you ought to get angry about. I get angry about injustice in the world. I get angry about racism in the world. I get angry when people go to bed at night hungry while others have more than they could possibly ever need. Anger is an evidence of love. In fact, the only reason you are able to get angry is because you were made in God's image. And the Bible says that God gets angry. God has emotions too. That's why you're an emotional person. In fact, 375 times in the Bible, it says that God got angry or Jesus got angry or the Holy Spirit got angry. There are some things that are definitely wrong and we ought to be angry about them. There's a righteous anger and an unrighteous anger. There's a right way and a wrong way. There's an appropriate way and there's an inappropriate way. Not all anger is sin. Selfish anger is sinful. Self-centered anger is sinful. Uncontrolled anger is sinful. But the Bible says that anger sometimes is the appropriate response. Sometimes it's helpful. But most of the time in our lives, it's harmful. Proverbs 12:16 says, "A fool is quick-tempered, but a wise man stays calm when insulted." It's wise to just let it roll off your back. A wise person stays calm when insulted. In fact, anger is a learned response. We learn it from other people. They may be bad examples, but we learned it from others. We learned it from television, we learned it from movies, we learned it from our parents, we learned it from other people in our life. The good news is that since it's learned, it can be unlearned. You can learn appropriate ways to deal with your anger. We should ask God to help us with that this week. Let me pray. Heavenly Father, help us to place our anger in the right places and express it appropriately. And help us to learn to deal with inappropriate and uncontrolled anger in our lives. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Hey, I hope you have a great day today and a fantastic week. God bless.